Hello viewers, today we will discuss basics of Zeeman effect. The outlines of this talk would be spectrum and its types, polarization of light and its analysis, effect of magnetic field upon a light source, and resolving power. Zeeman effect will be introduced and the types of Zeeman effect will be discussed, experimental demonstration of normal Zeeman effect, and we will comment. All of us know who is Faraday, and Faraday became very passionate to know about the impact of magnetic field on the spectrum of a light source. So he did the experiment. He kept a light source in a magnetic field and studied the spectrum emitted by the light source. But he could not observe any change in the spectrum due to the introduction of the magnetic field. So he considered that his experiment was a failure, or magnetic field do not have any impact on the spectrum of the light lamp. Later, Zeeman conceived the same idea and did the experiment. He realized that the spectrum showed some remarkable change in the presence of a magnetic field. So Zeeman realized the failure for Faraday's experiment, that the experiment was not a failure, but the instrument used by Faraday did not have high resolution. So he opted for a spectrograph that has high resolving power. All of us know, if the resolving power is very high, it could show very close objects, very close objects, as two independent objects. So Zeeman was very careful in choosing a spectrometer with high resolving power. And he repeated the same experiment which was done by Faraday. Now, let us see what is Zeeman effect. When a source of light giving line spectrum is placed in magnetic field, the spectral lines are split up into number of component lines symmetrically distributed about the original line is called Zeeman effect. So Zeeman chose a spectrometer with high resolving power. Also, he chose a light source that is giving out line spectrum. A lamp can give the spectrum. The spectrum can have continuous spectrum, line spectrum, and band spectrum. Zeeman did not choose the lamp that was giving a continuous spectrum and band spectrum, because his intention was, when the lamp is placed in a magnetic field, how the spectral lines are impacted. If he chooses a lamp source that is giving out a continuous spectrum or band spectrum, and when you apply the magnetic field, you cannot make out the difference. The continuous band is getting multiplied, the bands are again getting multiplied. It is not easy to distinguish. If you choose a lamp that is giving out a line spectrum, lines are very sharp lines. So when the magnetic field is applied, whether the number of lines is increasing or not can be easily studied. So he was careful to choose a lamp source that was giving out a line spectrum, so that the spectral study could be very easy. So he chose the lamp and kept it in the magnetic field. Now, he observed that in the presence of the magnetic field, each spectral line split up into many component lines symmetrically distributed along the about the original line, which is called Zeeman effect. Now, the types of Zeeman effect. There are two types. Normal Zeeman effect generally takes place in strong magnetic field, and another type is anomalous Zeeman effect that takes place when a weak magnetic field is applied. This normal Zeeman effect also having different types, right? The first one is normal longitudinal Zeeman effect. It is the splitting up of each spectral line into two components in strong magnetic field along the longitudinal view. This is called normal longitudinal Zeeman effect. Another type is that normal transverse Zeeman effect. This is once again splitting up of each spectral line into three components in a strong magnetic field along the transverse view. That is why it is called normal transverse Zeeman effect. Longitudinal Zeeman effect means you have to view the spectrum along the magnetic field, and he observed each line is splitting up into two components. Normal transverse Zeeman effect means you have to view the spectral lines in a direction perpendicular to the flow of magnetic lines of force. So he observed each line split up into three components. A normal Zeeman effect is that each spectral line was split up into many lines when a weak magnetic field was applied. In today's class, we will discuss only about normal Zeeman effect. Let us now discuss about the experimental setup. So he chose a light source that was giving out line spectra. In our lab, we have used sodium vapor lamp. We have used mercury vapor lamp. If you use a grating or a prism, you could observe the spectrum of the mercury vapor lamp or the sodium vapor lamp. When you use a grating or a prism, the spectrum had, suppose if it is a mercury vapor lamp, the spectrum has seven colors called vivgia. If you use a sodium vapor lamp, you will see only two lines. Okay, so that is as a lamp giving out line spectra. Why he chose a lamp that is giving out line spectrum is spectral study becomes easier. Then we have to apply a magnetic field. For that we need magnets. Zeeman designed the magnets in such a way that he drilled a hole along the length of the magnet. A magnet has north pole and south pole. It's an electromagnet. An iron piece, a long iron piece, is shaped into conical shape so that the flux lines get focused here. And a hole is drilled along this iron piece, on this piece as well as on this piece, so that the light can pass through this opening. Okay, now when you wind a coil on this iron piece and pass electric current, this iron piece becomes a magnet. So you call this magnet as an electromagnet, because this iron piece becomes a magnet in the presence of a current. Otherwise, it's just an iron piece only. And Zeeman used a spectrometer that has high resolving power. So spectrometer in our lab, we have used it as a collimator, it has a telescope. Collimator will be focused at the lamp or the light source, and the telescope attached with the eyepiece. You can move the telescope at any angle. So you move the telescope of the spectrometer or spectrograph and view in this direction. Or you move the telescope and take to this side and view the light in this direction. So this direction is parallel to the length of the magnet. Or I can say the flux lines are starting from the north pole and end at the south pole. So if your viewing angle is along the lines of magnetic lines of force, you call it as a longitudinal mode. So you can turn the telescope and take it to longitudinal view and view the spectral lines. Okay, you can also take the telescope or the spectrogram and keep here and view the light. Now this angle of viewing is perpendicular to the magnetic line, suppose. So this mode of viewing is called transverse view. So why he drilled a hole in the magnet? Now you understand, to have a longitudinal view. So Zeeman observed the light, took the light source and kept in the magnetic field. Now he is going to observe the spectral lines in longitudinal view as well as in transverse view. This is the experimental setup. Okay, next let us see, when there is no magnetic field was applied, he observed only a single spectral line in the spectrum. No magnetic field was applied, the spectrum showed only a single line. No magnetic field means V equal to zero. Further, he analyzed the spectral line using Nicol prism or tourmaline crystal, and he wanted to know whether any polarization has taken place. So when he tested, when he analyzed with the analyzer, he observed that in the absence of magnetic field, the line, the spectral line, what he got was unpolarized. That means the spectral line contained vibration in all direction. That is what unpolarized. Next, he moved the telescope in a direction perpendicular to the magnetic lines of force. This view is called transverse view. So this is normal Zeeman effect because the magnetic field chosen is very strong. But two different views, one is transverse view, another is longitudinal view. In transverse view, when he observed, there was a remarkable difference. The single line that appeared in the absence of the magnetic field now split up into three lines in transverse view. Then he used a polarizer and an analyzer and wanted to know the nature of polarization of these lines. Now magnetic field, strong magnetic field is there. Now when he analyzed, he observed all the three lines are linearly polarized. Linearly polarized means it contained vibrations only in one plane. And then he wanted to know whether any difference between these two lines and the middle line. He observed that the middle line was linearly polarized in a direction parallel to the upline magnetic field, whereas the other two lines are linearly polarized but perpendicular to the magnetic lines of force. This is what called normal transverse Zeeman effect. In the presence of the magnetic field, the original line splits up into three lines. The outer lines symmetrically placed about the original line, and all the three lines are linearly polarized. The original line or the middle line linearly polarized parallel to the applied magnetic field, and the outer lines are linearly polarized in a direction perpendicular to the applied magnetic field. This spacing between the outer line and the midline is called Zeeman shift. And this side also he observed Zeeman shift, and to his surprise, this delta nu remained the same. That means the outer lines are symmetrically placed about the original line. These are the observations he made when he viewed the spectral lines in transverse view. Next, you took the telescope and viewed along the longitudinal view, that is parallel to the magnetic field. Now he wanted to know whether any change was there in the spectrum. He observed a change. What is the change? In longitudinal view, the middle line is missing. He could see only the outer two lines in longitudinal view. And when he analyzed with the analyzer, he observed that both the lines are circularly polarized, one in the anticlockwise direction and the other one in the clockwise direction. So beautiful observation he made. In the absence of the magnetic field, the spectral line he obtained was single only and it was unpolarized. When a strong magnetic field is applied and when the spectrum is viewed in the transverse view, this single line split up into three lines, all the three lines linearly polarized, the midline linearly polarized parallel to the applied magnetic field, and the outer lines polarized in a direction perpendicular. Now he changed the view. He took the spectrometer telescope into longitudinal view. To his surprise, the middle line was missing and the outer two lines were present and they were circularly polarized, one in the anticlockwise direction and other in the clockwise direction. These are the experimental observations. What Faraday could not observe, Zeeman could observe because his spectrograph had high resolving power. Also, he viewed the spectrum in different perceptions, in different angle of view, so that he could get different observations. Now, Zeeman was successful and he got Nobel Prize. Presence of magnetic field split the spectral lines into many was the new idea. So, he got Nobel Prize for this experiment. Thank you all. I hope you have enjoyed this learning. Thank you.